In December 2022, the Constitutional Court ruled that it is illegal to try civilians in military courts. The judges, in a majority decision of 3-2, said under the 1995 Constitution, the trial of civilians is the role of civilian courts of judicature. However, the Attorney General, Chiriwa Chiwanuka, says the trial of civilians in military courts will continue because it was determined by the Supreme Court.
Decision. In law, we have a rule called the rule of precedent. We have decisions of the Supreme Court, and then we have decisions of the Court of Appeal. The decisions of the Supreme Court take precedence. So the decision of the Court of Appeal does not change the position of the Supreme Court. It's only the Supreme Court that can change its position.
Robert Chagulanyi's bodyguard, Anthony Agaba, also known as Bobby Young, is the latest civilian to be tried by the General Court Martial. On January 30th this year, Bobby Young was charged with spreading harmful propaganda, and he has been on remand ever since then. While appearing before the committee today, officials of the judiciary were asked to explain their position on the continued trial of civilians in the military courts despite constitutional court ruling.
They asked him a specific question, whether there's need to introduce an amendment in the bill to prohibit trial of civilians in the court martial. And his answer, one paragraph, civilians can be tried by the general court martial as determined in the case of Namugerwa Hadija versus Attorney General and the Director of Public Prosecution, Supreme Court Civil Appeal number 4 of 2012.
Civilians in the military courts. The good thing is that all our cases which have been handled by both by the Supreme Court and the Constitutional Court, they are all consistent. They have all come out and stated that there shouldn't be the trial of the civilians in the military court. And that is our voice as judiciary. That is how we speak.
The committee wondered how the judiciary reconciles the two contradicting decisions of the Court of Appeal and the Supreme Court, and which one takes precedence.
The Supreme Court was sitting as a quorum to determine a civil appeal. And they made this ruling, I think, by way of obiter. So we are telling the Attorney General the decisions of the Court of Appeal, sitting as a constitutional court, take precedence over this particular decision of the Supreme Court. His view is certainly different.
The judiciary's chief registrar, Sarah Langa, informed Parliament that the Internal Law Reform Committee is sitting soon to harmonize conflicting court judgments which are causing ambiguity in the legal system.
For some of them, we are sitting as management to sit and discuss what next, because even the Attorney General in that occasion was seeking guidance. So the guidance will certainly be given at the time when it is ready.
To add on that, we also have a reform committee of judiciary which looks at all those decisions and see where they conflict and what can be a way forward on how to harmonize.
The legal committee has therefore asked the judiciary to pronounce itself on the prohibition of trial of civilians in the court martial as soon as possible before Parliament passes the Law Revision Miscellaneous Amendments Bill 2022.
This question must be dealt with. Do you think that there is a way you can track this quickly before that commission to help us, I mean the committee to help us take a position on this matter?
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.